Hey everybody, it's Apes. I'm gonna show y'all how to use regular stamps to send small merch items like buttons and stickers and patches and CDs through the mail as letters, essentially, so that you could save money and ship things more efficiently. A lot of the time I see bands mailing these kind of items via first class package or media mail, but for small items, it actually is cheaper just to use stamps. And this is the first of a series I'm gonna be doing on DIY shipping and running a merch store from your house. In the next two videos, I'm gonna cover using PayPal to print your own shipping labels from home. And on the third video, I'm gonna be showing various hacks that I've been using regarding packaging and using different kinds of materials to send things for as cheaply as possible. So let's just dive right into it. The USPS allows you to send things using postage stamps as long as they meet certain size, weight, and thickness criteria. So what I have here is actually a template that I was able to get from my post office. You could probably ask for one. And it's just basically a cheat sheet. It has all the size regulations on it, and it also has this nifty little slot that you can use to slide letters through to make sure they meet the criteria for thickness. I'm gonna bring this back later, but first I'm gonna show y'all the envelopes that we're gonna use in this video. So the first one is your standard letter size envelope. And the second one is a 6x9 greeting card size or invitation envelope. And these are really good for mailing CDs and things like that. You could order them online or buy them at a store. I got this box from Staples. Okay, so stamps. There's a lot more stamps available at the post office than I think a lot of people realize. The first one we're gonna use in this video is your typical Forever USA first class mail stamp that's worth 55 cents and is good for mailing things up to 1 ounce. The second one, which I don't have one handy, is a non-machinable letter surcharge stamp that's worth 70 cents. It's good for mailing things up to 2 ounces, and it's good for mailing things that meet non-machinable criteria, which is anything that can't be pre-sorted through the mail machines. For our purpose, it's things that don't have a consistent thickness. So for example, I use them when I mail buttons. The third stamp that we're gonna use in this video is the 3 ounce stamp. So these are good for mailing things up to 3 ounces, and they have Walt Whitman on them. The fourth stamp is these really nifty little additional ounce stamps. So these are worth 15 cents and they're good for adding an additional ounce onto any pre-existing stamp you have. So for example, if I wanted to mail something that I needed 70 cents to mail, so a non-machinable letter, but I didn't have a non-machinable stamp handy, I could just use one of these 55 cent Forever USA stamps and then add one of these on the additional ounce stamp, and that equals 70 cents. So I could use this in place of a non-machinable stamp, or I could also add one of these onto a non-machinable stamp in order to get to 3 ounces. So these are really handy. I always try to keep a couple of these around. And the last one is a Global Forever first class letter stamp. These are good for mailing first class letters overseas. So sometimes you need to use these in conjunction with an additional ounce stamp depending on what you're mailing, but I use these to mail patches and stickers overseas. Hey, patches. You can mail patches using a first class letter stamp in a standard size envelope, like so. You just throw your patch in there. This is a regular like 3x5 or 4x4 square patch. It kind of just fits in the envelope. And then I also have these longer ones that sometimes I have to fold to get in there. So you just shove them in, seal them up, throw your stamp on. I have a postage scale. I got this one for like 15 bucks. If you're gonna be mailing stuff from home a lot, I really recommend that you buy them. Just to double check and show y'all that this is under an ounce. Right there, it's 0.7 of an ounce. I don't know if you can see the screen on the scale, but it's 0.7. So this will be perfect to send with a letter, first class letter stamp. But say you have a patch that's a little bigger and it's not gonna fit inside a regular envelope. I'm gonna use this Porch Cat patch that I just got in the mail as an example. And they actually sent this to me the exact way that I'm gonna show you right now. You get your greeting card size letter envelope, your 6x9 envelope. just put your patch in there. Now you could still, because this meets the criteria for weight, it's under an ounce, it's only 0.4 of an ounce, you could still mail this with a first class stamp. So just to prove that, here's my template, and here is the slot. So it fits through the slot, which means you don't need a non-machinable stamp yet. You could still mail this with just one regular first class stamp. Okay, stickers. You could do the same thing with stickers, throw them in a regular standard size envelope with a first class letter stamp. You could put as many as you want in there as long as it stays under 1 ounce, or you're gonna have to use the next level of stamp. So the only thing to be careful with this, see that's 0.8 of an ounce, so I would be good. The only thing to be careful with is that you don't want to have too much variance in thickness. So because these move around sometimes and all end up in like one corner of the envelope like that, you just got to be careful that you don't end up with something like this happening, or you're going to need to use a non-machinable stamp, because otherwise it will get torn up by the machine and it's not going to be a good time. Buttons. Okay, here's where things get a little tricky. Buttons, because they cause an uneven thickness in the envelope, you're safer sending them with a non-machinable letter stamp than a first class stamp. I've gotten away with doing them just with a first class stamp, but I've also had them sent back to my house and I've had them get ripped up. So just to be safe now, I usually use a non-machinable stamp. And what I actually do to help mitigate things is I take the buttons and I put them on a piece of paper, and then I tape said buttons to the said piece of paper so that they aren't moving around within the envelope too much. And then I just throw that in the envelope, put my non-machinable stamp on it, and I send it out. This is 0.5 ounces, so it's under the limit of 2 ounces, which is what you need for a non-machinable stamp. But I had some trouble recently because I had these buttons made, and these are a little bit larger. These are like a 1.25 inch button. And as you can see, they're also like a little bit thicker than your standard button. So these caused a problem for me because I sent them with a non-machinable stamp, but as you can see with this measuring tape, they were like, with this part that sticks out where the pin connects, it was just at like a quarter of an inch, which is the limit. And they were having trouble fitting through the slot. So some of them got sent back to me. Because of that, I haven't found a great way to send them cheaply. It's about 50-50 on whether they get sent back to me or not. Something you could do to try to help mitigate that if you're trying to mail buttons or items that are really close to the thickness is to use like a piece of paper and kind of attach it with tape, and just to like give it some rigidity, and then put it in that way. And you could try to get away with it that way. I'm gonna shove this through the slot just to show you that it's very close. So sometimes I get these through the post office, sometimes I don't. See how it kind of hesitates to go through and it needs to be like pushed through? The lady at the post office told me that they're not supposed to have to push it, and right now it's like getting completely stuck. If they have to push it through, they'll reject it. So sometimes they go through, sometimes they don't. Just play it safe when you mail those kind of things. Last but not least, we have CDs. This, I think, is the most useful thing you will get out of this video, because first class package starts at retail $3.80. And if you're buying commercial, that's $2.74. And media mail starts at $2.80. So a lot of the time I see bands send CDs like this through media mail and first class mail, but you're wasting money if you're doing that. You could totally get away with using stamps. I have done this hundreds of times at this point. I've never had them arrive damaged. I've never had them come back to me. So this is proven. You're gonna use your 6x9 envelope, your greeting card size envelope, and you're just gonna throw your CD in there. I put them in this way because sometimes the discs slip out And if I put it in this way, I'm always just like concerned that it's gonna move around and get scratched and things like that. But you just throw it in there. I don't use any bubble wrap or anything like that, because guess what? This is sturdy, it's made of cardboard. CDs are made of plastic, which is like the most durable material that we've ever invented on planet Earth. So you don't really need much protection on that. If you're gonna put bubble wrap in here, you honestly, I think you're just wasting money, because I've never had them arrive damaged. Seal it up, throw on here your 70 cent non-machinable stamp. Just to show you the weight, this weighs 1.2 ounces. So the non-machinable stamp is good to mail things up to 2 ounces. So you're solid on this. And just to show you this thickness, it fits through the slot very easily, no hesitation. So you're good to go. You could also continue and mail multiple CDs at once with this method. So just to show you how many I could fit. That's 2 CDs, okay? It weighs 1.8 ounces. So at this point, I'm still good with using a non-machinable 70 cent stamp. One time, the lady at the post office told me, because this is like rigid, that I should use a 3 ounce, the Walt Whitman stamp that I showed you earlier. But honestly, I still don't do that ever, because I'm cheap and I like to save money. And I haven't had it happen where they've got sent back yet. You can, for good measure, just write non-machinable across the bottom, and that'll, non-machinable, and also you could write do not bend across the bottom, and that'll, maybe they'll be convinced to not destroy your package. But okay, just to show you, this does fit through easily still, okay? And let's try with 3 and see how that goes. I don't know that I've ever mailed 3 CDs at once, but let's just try it. Okay, so now we're at 2.6 ounces. We're still under 3.5 ounces, which is what you have to be under to still use stamps to mail things. But, and I'm sensing this isn't gonna work because, oh, nope, you know what? It does still go through. Okay, so I've never tried this before, but if anybody wants to try mailing 3 CDs at once using a 3 ounce stamp, you could probably get away with it because it does fit through. And if they did give you trouble, I would ask them why, because that seems like it would work. I don't see why it wouldn't. Okay, so international stuff. You're just gonna pretend for that, like these Global Forever stamps is your standard 1 ounce first class letter stamp, and proceed as you would. So for patches, you just throw it in, you use your first class mail stamp, international, you write the address, and you're good to go. Technically, you're supposed to declare things, anything that isn't like a document, you're supposed to declare it through customs. So this is iffy. I've gotten away with it a lot. I've actually never had one sent back, so I get away with it pretty much all the time with patches and stickers. I have gotten away with it with buttons too, and I haven't had them send back. I've also gotten away with sending CDs, to Canada and to Europe using these first class letter stamps, international stamps, and an additional ounce stamp to make it basically like a faux non-machinable international letter. And they've gotten through. The only reason I say proceed with caution is because, like I said, you're supposed to declare anything that isn't a document to customs, and technically a CD is not a document. So you're bypassing customs if you do this. Not highly recommended unless you want to get in trouble for mail fraud, but it works and it's cheap, so meh, whatever. So that's it, folks. I hope you found this helpful and useful. If you learned something from it and you want to support me, I'm gonna post a link to my PayPal and Venmo in the comments below. If you want to throw me anything, that would be much appreciated. If not, that's totally cool too. I'm just in this to try to help y'all out and help y'all save money, because it infuriates me every time a band sends me merch and they're spending way too much on postage. Like I said, this is the first of a video series I'm going to be doing on DIY shipping stuff. So to be like a typical YouTuber, like and subscribe so that you get a notification when I put the next video up. The next video is going to be on using PayPal to print shipping from home, print postage from home, so that you save money by using commercial pricing. Have a good one.